I be getting to the money. Everybody mad. Think I'm getting too much money. Everybody mad.
What's up, Wealth Babe? Welcome back to my channel. If you are new, welcome to the channel. Please be sure to hit that subscribe button and also click the bell to turn on post notifications if you're interested in more wealth building content. In today's video, I want to talk about cutting back on expenses. So let's go ahead and hop right into the video. So let's be honest, we can definitely all use a little more money to just have fun with or cover some of our financial needs. Now, you may think that increasing your income will solve all of your financial worries, but I'm here to tell you that that is far from the case. So you may have heard statistics about how if you can't properly manage $1,000, then you surely won't be able to properly manage $100,000. And I think that is very much so. That is very truthful. You may have even heard statistics about lottery winners. And the statistic that I've heard is lottery winners typically spend all of that money that they win and have absolutely nothing to show for it and find themselves back in financial crisis. So what we need to do is not worry so much about increasing our income, although yes, we should, but more of that focus should be around your money management skills. So let's begin to hone our money management skills, because to be honest, if you start to increase your income and you don't learn good money skills, then you'll find that even by time you make as much money as you probably ever will, by then you won't even care about making sure that you can budget well. And that's just truthful. I think that by the time you earn a lot of money and you still have bad financial habits, then you'll find yourself doing the same things and in the same crises that you had when you didn't have as much money, such as living paycheck to paycheck, or even borrowing money that you can't even repay, or just racking up on credit card debt and paying hella interest over your lifetime. So again, let's go ahead and hone our money management skills, and the time to do that was like yesterday. So let's go ahead and talk about this technique that will help you. So I want to share a technique that you can use to help with your money management skills. And this tool or technique is specifically used to help you cut back on expenses and assist with where you should start with cutting back and in that whole budgeting process. So the basis of this technique is around our needs versus our wants. And as you know, you should know if you don't already, we must prioritize our needs over our wants. And believe it or not, there are people in this world who will go out and buy something that they want without having the money in that same month to cover their necessities. So we don't want to fall victim to that spending habit as wealth babe. So make sure that you just totally prioritize all of your needs over your wants. That's just start there. But then we have two types of expenses that we incur. We have fixed expenses and then we have variable expenses. So fixed expenses is when your money that you're paying that expense month over month is fixed. It's consistent. And then variable needs is the opposite. It means that the money that you're paying typically varies. So with that, we have four categories. We have fixed needs, we have variable needs, we have fixed wants, and we have variable ones. So types of fixed needs includes your mortgage or your rent, or your car note or insurance. And then you have variable needs, which in this category would be gas or groceries. And then you have your fixed wants, which would include things like your cable or your internet bill. And then you may have subscription bills such as Netflix or Amazon Prime. And then that fourth category would be your variable wants, which would include entertainment, so tickets to events, or maybe you're going out to restaurants, and also in this category would be shoes or clothes. So you're probably wondering why I put these expenses in an inverted pyramid. And the reason is because this pyramid helps put into perspective where we need to start when we are cutting back on expenses or when we are recalibrating our budget. So you've probably already figured out by now that when we want to start cutting back on expenses, we need to start with our variable wants. Now, if you're trying to meet a financial goal, you might not have to cut back on everything in your variable wants category, but this is where you start and you begin to cut back on all of those expenses if you can't meet your financial goal with just cutting back on one of the expenses or two of the expenses in the variable wants category. So keeping that same logic, if you needed to meet a financial goal and you found that you cut back on everything that was in your variable wants category, you would then start to tackle your fixed wants category. So with that, you would cut back on those expenses that are in your fixed wants category. And then keeping that same logic, you would just go down this inverted pyramid. So you would then hit your variable needs category. You need to start making some adjustments to what you're spending or how much you're spending on the items in your variable needs category. And finally, if you're in desperate times and you really have already cut back on all of the expenses in your variable needs category, then you need to just start reevaluating your life and asking yourself questions such as, why am I paying this money for this mortgage or this apartment? So I'm talking about the items that are in the fixed needs category now, and asking yourself questions such as, do I need to have this car? And if not, can I start to swap out and get rid of this car? Start to reevaluate where you are with your variable wants, move down to your fixed wants, and then you need to start doing some serious reevaluation and recalibration if you find that when you cut back on those extra expenses, you're still not able to make ends meet. But all in all, just make sure that you don't fall into the trap of thinking that increasing your income will solve your financial problems. You need to be a master of managing your money properly. That's it for now, Wealth Babe. Let's hone our money management skills and also budget realistically. Let me know in the comments below if your variable wants have ever gotten out of control. And also give this video a thumbs up if you found that this inverted pyramid is helpful for you and or will be helpful to you when you start to look at your budget. And as always, remember that if you're not fully, truly, and totally committed to building wealth, then chances are you won't. Mwah.